Now let's be honest. When you buy a Battlefield game, you don't buy it for the single player. Battlefield is a multiplayer game, and it will always be the main focus for me. And this game does not disappoint with the multiplayer. But can the game possibly live up to the legacy of Battlefield 2? The game is different, but does not sacrifice any of the fun or awesomeness of the multiplayer the series has been known for. It is your good old Battlefield, but there have been some changes to the Battlefield formula that has worked out so well in the past. Like previous Battlefield games, you pick from one of four classes, each with their own function to perform for the team. First off, I feel the need to mention the change to me that is the biggest. Gone now is the medic class. Remember those guys who would run around throwing out med packs to everyone except the time when you desperately needed one? Well, that class is gone and replaced with the support class. Returning is your assault, engineer, and recon classes. This time, the assault class is the one who hands out those needed med packs. The engineer continues to repair slash destroy the vehicles, and they load out with submachine guns. And the recon class is your snipers who are too afraid to actually get into the real fight. The new support class comes with a light machine gun and is used to take advantage of the new cover fire system, which is really cool when used properly. Like in real life, people are a little afraid of getting shot and can't be too accurate when being rained down upon by a lead hailstorm. So when you fire at an enemy, their screen will go fuzzy and their controls will slow down, making it difficult for them to hit you. So used by the team, this can make battles very strategic and fun. You have the support class provide cover fire while the assault takes out the enemies while they're shaken. This is great in theory, but you also need a team that is focused on doing this and not just running around guns ablazing at the enemy. The maps are another thing that is really impressive, and they show off the abilities of the Frostbite 2 engine nicely. The maps are huge, and I mean it. Huge. In some maps, if you don't get into a Jeep once you deploy, expect to have to take a long run before you even see the enemies. You really appreciate the size of the maps when you're playing rush mode. One team is out to destroy certain markers, while the other team has to defend them. If the attacking team succeeds in destroying them, then you fall back and have to defend another group. Each time this happens, more of the map is opened up, and you can go multiple matches before even seeing the entire map. One thing that might not be accepted is the new Team Deathmatch mode. The game maps have been shrunk down to a small confined area, making the action much faster. This was obviously designed to directly compete with Call of Duty, which makes me a little disappointed. I always thought Battlefield was above that. Yeah, most of the time people ignore the objectives and treat each match like Team Deathmatch, but you still had some people out there playing to win. In the end, it is the Battlefield you know and love, or it's still the Battlefield you have always hated. It brings you in with its deep unlock system, open maps, and game modes. Any type of player will find something great about this game to enjoy.